first experiment will be burning magnesium. This metal reacts with the biggest to the fire, such as glowing brightly, making a sparkling sound. There were a bit of sparks. There was white ash on the tongs after the experiment. The magnesium itself had turned white and crumbled into small pieces of ash. When we burned the copper, the color in it went kind of like a rainbow during heating, changing its colors throughout the process. After a while, it went black due to the extreme heat of the Bunsen burner. We burned the magnet until it started glowing. The fire went blue, then we tried to see if other magnets were still attracted to it. It wasn't at first, but then it started to become attractive. Try to sprinkle a fair amount of iron filling, or iron powder, on the fire because we wanted to see whether or not there was a different reaction, seeing as it was still made out of metal. We found that they created small sparks in the fire, flying about everywhere. It looked a bit like fireworks when we tried to knock some of the powder into the fire. In this experiment, we burned zinc foil. It had a glowing blue flame, and it turned hard. It had a moldy color. It glowed an orange-ish when burned. It quickly turned hard. The wood made a bright glowing orange fire. The wood turned into a black dust after burning. It stuck to the tongs and there were black ash remains.
I'm sorry if this hurts you, but I tried to keep what we had once. I was wrong. It wasn't keeping me awake.
For a fire to work, you need to have three things: fuel, oxygen, and heat. The heat could be the starting match. The fire is transferred to a splint, which lights the fire. The oxygen is found in the air. When a fire is trapped, it will run out of oxygen and eventually die out. The fuel, for example, the gas in the Bunsen burner, could be what the fire sits on, like the wood on a bonfire.